Watching Talking About. I'm John Griffith, and it is my pleasure to introduce a familiar face to you, and one that you're going to get to know a lot better in a moment or two. But first, he's going to bless us with a song. So welcome, Mr. Ruben Navarro.
No man or woman, of what state or condition he be, shall be put out of his lands or tenements, nor taken, nor disinherited, nor put to death, without he be brought to answer by due process of law. When I was a boy, I saw my daddy crying at the steering wheel. It made me feel so scared. Then there was joy, found my religion swimming in a choir of voices. I knew
talking about. That was amazing, and I want to again welcome Ruben Navarro.
Thank you for having me. That was awesome. Thank you, sir.
How did you catch your breath so quickly?
Ah, you know what? I had a professional side of me. Yeah. I took a very deep breath beforehand.
Okay, yeah. So the title of that song was?
It is called Keep Singing.
Okay.
No, it's the title song of the show that I'm doing. Hopefully tomorrow, we'll see. Okay. But that was written and first performed by Rick Astley. And the minute that I heard it, I fell in love with the song. Mm. And it's from his recent album. I believe it was this last summer. But still, it was such a great song. I knew that I really, really wanted to do it. So thank you, Mr. Astley, for writing the song.
Okay. it's always wonderful to have such amazingly talented artists come in here and perform in front of us, and it gives me a lot of joy to share that with our audience as well, you know, the 10 or 12 of you who are watching. But
well, thank you very much. And you know, that's the first time that I've actually sung live on a talk show, I believe that is, especially with the earpiece. Okay. So I felt very, very professional. I feel like I'm growing up with you, really.
Well, actually, it's like this is a first, because we've been out of this particular studio for over a year, because the studio that we'd been in was HD upgraded first, and then the 6-month project of redoing this studio ended up taking a year and a half.
Wow! So that's a very nice
here
studio.
We are.
Thank you for having me.
It's like you're breaking. You're helping us break it in.
Thank you. You can really see these pores. You really can. Yeah. No, thank you for having me.
As long as
you
can hear the sound, that's
that's right. That's right.
Yeah, you can see the talent. The pores are the talent.
Pores are talented, I guess. Yeah.
So the show is going on.
Keep Singing is hopefully tomorrow.
Okay.
I was talking to you earlier. It seems that every time I schedule a show ahead of time, 3-4 months is usually a good time. I start thinking about what I'm going to do. There is a blizzard. Mm. Or a storm of some kind. So I had to, I did a show on I planned to do a show on Valentine's Day in 2015, and it was 1 degree that day, and I think there was 8 inches of snow in Long Island. I have a lot of friends and I consider family now on Long Island, and I thought they're never going to be able to be here. So I canceled the show. And I now regret, but had to do it again, or actually schedule the show for May 18th of the following, the same year. And I believe it was storming or something was going on. But still, of course, the show is hopefully going on tomorrow night at 7 p.m. at the Triad Theater on 72nd Street. The doors open at 6:30, and those tickets are still available. There's still plenty of seats. I'm hoping that I can try and fill the space.
Okay, and I'm sure.
And that people are going to be able to get there, and
yes,
the place will be open.
Yes, well, the subways are underground.
The subways are underground.
The subways are underground.
That's right.
So definitely hop on the train and get your boat over there.
Yeah.
But
I see ya.
Being that the internet is forever and the reruns go on and on, so you have a whole lot of other stuff going on.
There's
as well.
There's a lot going on. I think the last time I was on your show, I was I still considered myself a professional. I was doing a lot of background work, film and television that films in New York, and that's actually why I moved here, was to pursue more film and television work. So luckily, since then, I have been working nonstop. Thank goodness. There's so much going on, and with all of these new studios that are opening, thank goodness, there's a lot more work to be had in New York City for.
And more things are shooting here, which is
wonderful. Yes, exactly. Which is great for our economy.
Mm-hmm.
And as I was saying, I was a non-union performer then, which there's still a lot of non-union work. But since then, I've become a member of the union, which has been absolutely fantastic and opens up a new world of opportunities. So I'm really, really happy about that, because it's a lot of hard work that goes into
just getting to that point.
Into becoming a member of the union and being able to say, I am hopefully now a professional. But there's a lot going on besides the family back in Texas are the only ones that post. This internet thing is very interesting, and I'd like to talk about that. But I stopped posting the stills that I was taking of myself on the internet from the corner of my elbow or the back of my head.
I enjoy those.
Because, it's like we know we're on set, and, I'm still, I get so excited to be on set and, you know, to follow the stars that I grew up with, mm-hmm. you know? So to be on set is still very exciting to me, and there's so much more you have to pay attention and watch and see what you're doing, and there's booms and things, so it's very technical, but that kid in me, especially, you know, is like, oh my God, I can't believe that I'm on the set, and that mm-hmm. I get to be a part of this on ABC or NBC or CBS mm-hmm. or, you know, in a big film, and all of a sudden there's a corner of your ear and you get really excited.
I know that, Freckle.
That's my ear. sometimes, if you don't end up on the cutting room floor. But there's a lot of new stuff coming on, and a lot more this summer, just like every season or every year has mm-hmm. the slow season. So luckily we're coming out of the slow season again and into pilot season.
Right, we're in the middle of pilot season.
In the middle of pilot season, yes.
Because the ongoing series usually wrap around March and then pick up again in July.
Correct, yeah.
So, and in the interim, all the networks and cable companies are ordering, you know, the pilot films, and a lot of casting opportunities, hopefully there.
Definitely.
Hopefully.
I hope so. There was one pilot last year, actually, that I was lucky enough to start off the pilot episode, and it got picked up. So luckily there was a lot of work this season, and you will see a lot of that.
Okay.
I don't know if I can say TV show.
If you're
Deception, which I tend to hoard my television shows and wait for one Sunday when I know nothing is going on.
Okay.
And watch them all at one time. So my family is in Texas, and I stopped posting those pictures of my ear, but this time there was a nice, you know, not to say full frontal, but there was a nice shot of my face that my cousin posted on TV, and I thought, oh wow, that's fantastic. And I still haven't gone back to see the entire episode yet, but still, that Deception on ABC, and I'm very excited about the rest of the season, because it's a really original idea, mm-hmm. and a very exciting show, and, you know.
Yeah, just something completely separate. I have some friends who are in a band, and you know, they've been trying to pitch their music to different shows as well, and they one of the things that they got was one of their songs on Shameless.
Wow!
And they were touring at the time, and they were staying with like a friend's mother in this tiny town, and they wanted to watch the episode. So they're sitting there with this elderly woman. And like the episode was called "Come for Grandma" or something. And it was one of the most.
And they came for Grandma, didn't
adult,
they?
Yeah, adult-oriented episodes that an adult-oriented series features.
Always.
And they're sitting there with this relative stranger of a little old lady watching somebody come for Grandma. So
yes, which is always the way it happened. And you know, I it's odd. I don't really think about. I used to think, oh, that's a coincidence. Oh, that's a coincidence. That's a coincidence. In New York City, it just doesn't seem like there's very many coincidences anymore. You know, reading the paper and all of the crazy things that are going on. That's what my show is about too. Is these strange little circumstances that we find ourselves in, like being backstage, you know, on one of these major network television mm-hmm. shows, and the idea of being a kid and imagining myself as a, you know, as an adult and what I would be doing. You know, and I always wanted to be an actor or a doctor or an astronaut or a scientist. And, you know.
Well, as an actor, you can be all of those things.
As an actor, I can be all of them. But now I just play them on TV, I hope. But, you know, that's what the show is about, is these weird coincidences, and the way that like I got to meet you through a friend on radio, mm-hmm. all of these little miracles are starting to fuel what I do on stage now. So I never imagined that being on TV and getting to that point it's enough. Mm-hmm. There's the excitement is incredible. But now that I've started writing about being backstage and meeting people like you and being on these kinds of sets is what's starting to fuel the creativity. And, you know, and I never imagined that's what would make me so much more excited than being on set. And luckily, you know, now that's what I get to do, and hopefully get to do that tomorrow mm-hmm. for an audience with a lovely yeah. band and some great backup singers.
Yeah. Well, you're going to do it tomorrow. It's just
Yes, I am.
We need to get the audience there.
Yes, we are going to do it tomorrow. 158 West 72nd at the Triad Theater.
Okay.
Yes.
Very nice.
Yes.
Because this is what you do to make ends meet. And this is what you do. This is your livelihood. And this well, is
and that's
this is your love.
It is. This is my love. And you know, I loved sitting there and watching Jason and Jeffrey, because it, you know, I think as an actor, this is what I wanted to do. And I'm not sure if people under this is my job. You know, this is the promotion part of it, and the you get the idea, and from beginning, I thought of this show a year ago on the subway, and I started writing down all of these thoughts. Mm-hmm. So the show is a collection of gospel. It was jazz, gospel, pop, rock. Now it's a little more gospel and pop, with the idea that after the election, there were so many things that were woven together. Because of the film and TV and the election, all happened, everything was happening at the same time. November was a really, really busy time. So I started writing these tiny little things in my notes, and that all of a sudden became a show. So the songs that tie it together are Madonna's Living for Love, which my musical director helped me put together an arrangement of Mozart's Rex Tremendae, interwoven with Madonna's Living for Love, okay. helping illustrate the point of that superheroes seem to come out of, you know, the woodwork whenever we as a nation start, you know, going through really tough times and things are a little uneasy, and all of a sudden there's a ton of superheroes on film and TV helping to somehow ease the nation's worry somehow. So that's what I'm trying to convey in the show as well, that, you know, that there aren't really very many coincidences left, especially if you take New York as kind of a microcosm. Mm-hmm. You know, an island is an island, and things are falling into place more than we would like to admit.
Okay.
On purpose.
Okay.
Yeah. Or it did for the show, anyway. Everything seemed to fall into place, and the pieces of the puzzle just started sticking
but
together.
But it's amazing how the little slips of paper grow into an idea, into a segment, and into a full show.
Exactly.
I think I read years ago an interview with Carol Burnett, and she was just writing her first book, and she didn't know how to do it, and somebody just told her to write a page a day, and in a year you'll have a book.
Yeah, and that's what I was saying about Jason and Jeffrey, is that it just takes an idea, and it's that idea of how do we? I coincidentally also went through a lot of what Jason has gone through, and the addiction, and the struggles, and the being down and out, and not having absolutely anything left, and having absolutely no idea what hope is about, and walking in the sun with other people and looking at people directly in the eye and feeling so horrible and hollow inside, and the only thing that you have left is that tiny, tiny little bit of hope, and you write that down, and you write something else down, and then you take something else, and all of a sudden it's built up, and then before you know it, one foot in front of the other, and now it's a show, and something that I hope will convey a sense of hope to other people as well. Because, I mean, I know if I can do it, and I mean, it's not over, but, you know, I'm sure if you ask Jeffrey or Jason as well, if you thought when you were at your lowest point that you would ever rise above it, you'd say no. But, you know, it's really nice. It's nice to look up and say, wow, I did that. And still not feel like you're completely selfish for being an actor, or, you know, for being your own business, you know. Because that's tough sometimes.
Right, well, I mean, life goes on around you, and you're on your own path, your own road. Yeah. And sometimes there are potholes in the road, and sometimes there's always something to get around or overcome. And if you're fortunate enough to be able to see that you come through it stronger, and you can use your personal experience and education about that road to help somebody else along that road who's coming behind you. And the best people that I know have done just that. Yeah, they've taken their life experience and just helped somebody along to get through theirs a little bit easier, and hopefully that passes along from person to person.
I hope so. And how to do that, and how do you do that? Sometimes you just, again, put one foot in front of the other. And luckily, again, no coincidences, how you meet people, or where you find yourself, and also how you manage to pull yourself out, or who just says hello from out of no place, and mm-hmm. how that turns into a friendship or help in some way. Yeah, and being able to say help helps too.
Yeah, well,
it is hard to do a lot of the time.
Oh, asking for help is one of the hardest things in the world to do for some people. Yeah. And I think at one point or another, everybody needs to learn how to do that. And sometimes the hardest thing in the world is to know how to accept a compliment without becoming defensive.
Yeah, or know how to drop the crack pipe.
Probably, yeah. that might be something that's worth doing.
Yeah, no, that's always good.
Yeah, or at least put it down for a few minutes more each day.
Yes, there you go.
Then a few minutes more the next day.
Or sugar, or whatever your vice could be. Lately, it's so odd to be so close to the center of the universe and where everything films here. I mean, there's a lot. It's either here or LA, and there's so much mm-hmm. about our bodies and how we must look a certain way. And this is the crazy thing, I think, that I wanted to mention about the internet is there's this idea that, and I'm just as guilty of, double clicking on, the big beefy guy with the hairy chest, that parades around in his underwear.
Where is he?
There's a lot of them out there, John. But, there's these ideals that constantly have to be this thing. And, I'm just not good enough. I'm not good enough. And, when you see enough of this, or you get hooked or addicted to this enough, mm-hmm. I think to get to the point was I actually pulled back from Facebook and from Twitter as well. Now, mm-hmm. I've gotten them off my phone and only, for business. Really. Mm-hmm. And I never thought I'd use Facebook or Twitter for business. But, it's a huge part of our business,
you know,
to promote the show. And it's tough to, compete with, the big boobied, DILFs and MILFs out there. But it can be done, I hope. Not that I don't like it. However, keep them coming. Right?
Now you made me lose my thought. You made me lose my train of thought.
I blush too. Hope.
Yeah, and everybody needs some, and everybody should share some.
Yes. I've got a couple of other shows coming up as well. So I'm going to be doing a show tomorrow at the Triad Theater, and then luckily I was cast as Walter White, the NAACP civil rights leader for Falcon Works Theater, and that show is up May 14th, I believe.
Okay.
And then I'm going to get to play a role that I've actually always wanted to play, Sancho Panza. I'm going to be actually singing I Like Him in Plymouth, Massachusetts, so I'm really excited. That's this summer, but keep going.
So you have a lot of good
stuff. There's a lot of good stuff going on, yeah.
So do you have a primary website that people can
I don't have a primary website yet.
Okay.
I'm looking into it, but that would mean getting back on the internet. And for now, Instagram is enough, and that's Ruben Navarro NYC.
Okay. And maybe a few more pictures of the corner of your ear that'll show up
there? There's going to be a few more pictures of the corner of my ear, maybe an elbow.
Okay.
My nose, the profile. Got a lot of the profile.
Okay.
Yeah. We'll see.
Any other parts?
Not yet, for now. I'm sticking to theater for just a little tiny while and doing a little background here and there to help make ends meet, mm-hmm. which has luckily been absolutely incredible. Thank you, casting. Wonderful.
That's good.
But again, there's so much going on that I'm hopeful again that there's going to be
that's
steady
good.
Work
I'm
out
I'm
there.
I'm happy
it's
for
picking
you.
Picking up.
Yeah. And yeah. You put good energy out, you get good things back, and
yes,
that's really
sir. Definitely.
That's really what it comes down to.
Definitely. And I'm going to keep singing. I'll always keep singing.
Okay. Well, maybe the next time you're here, you can do more than one tune for us.
Fantastic.
I know initially your accompanist was supposed to be with you, but life got in the way.
Yes.
And
sciatica got in the way, I believe is what it is. And
that's part of life, unfortunately.
It is. So rest is always good, especially right before the show.
Yeah.
Please get better.
Oh, my hip, my elbow.
Oh, my elbow, my sciatica.
Yeah.
But yes.
When you're little, it's head and shoulders, knees and toes. And then it's on my head, on my shoulders, my knees, my toes.
Yeah,
they
not
hurt.
Not so much anymore. I can't high kick like I used to.
Okay, well, we'll find you some motivation. but okay, so the Instagram and sporadically on the Facebook.
Sporadically on the Facebook. Twitter, I just don't understand the Twitter. There's hashtags and things, and I just, with Nancy Pelosi battling the Ronald. I just can't, whatever his name is. There's just a lot. It's way
lot
too much.
Yeah, sometimes you just
I stick to my Ancient Aliens and my songs and you and my BFFs, and I'm good.
Okay, and it's been really good to have you with
Thank
me.
Thank you for having
and
me, sir. Thank you so much.
Hopefully you'll be back with us again soon and bless
you.
Us with more performance. And Carl will be here to enjoy it next time, because I don't think you've met Carl yet.
So I haven't met Carl yet.
So next time you will.
Wonderful. Thank you for having me.
Thank you for being here, and
thank you
for being here also. I am John Griffith. There is more episodes and segments on our YouTube page, so Google that, and www.talkingabout.info takes you to the website. Eventually, that's going to just go to the YouTube page, so keep checking us out. Keep watching. Thank you so much for joining us, and thank you for being part of my evening. It's been
thank
wonderful.
So much.
We'll see you next time.